as you probably know, I am Alex from the YouTube channel eDrive. Well, in this video, I like to show you the CanSetE app on the cell phone. With that app, you can check different datas and things of your Renault Zoe car. This is the symbol of the app. Well, it's hard to get the focus on my cell phone. I connected the cell phone always with a power cable, direct with the cigarette lighter here, that I always have power on my cell phone. Then, that this app is working, you need a Bluetooth dongle to connect it to the OBD2 port of your Renault Zoe car. The thing is, on the Q model with the Q engine, only this specific Conway Bluetooth dongle is working. I will put a link from Amazon below this video so you can order it there if you like, or you see exactly which dongle it is. Because before I tried already two different dongles, for example this one, and yes, you can connect it, the app is connecting to the Bluetooth dongle, but the update of the numbers of the things, the update in the app is very, very slow. Means very slow. With the Conway dongle, with this one, the updates are done maybe every second, maybe every 1.5 seconds, something like this. But with that dongle, the update is done every minute, sometimes every 2 minutes. That's very, very, very slow. You can not really use it. To open this below first time, you need a plastic card, maybe ATM card or something like this, and you can put it here between. I know it's very hard the first time to open this, and then below you can see the plug, and then you can access this plug. If you open this and like to plug it here, you can see this dongle is very, very big, very high, so you can never ever close this anymore here because it's way too big. Because of that, I bought an extension cable. You can see it here. The plug is very, very small and the cable is very thin. So I can plug this cable here. And I'm easily able to close this here without any problem. So it's closed and I can use this for putting my things inside here. Then I need to connect this dongle here to this extension cable, and it works really fine. Maybe later on I will try to find a place that I can put this dongle here inside, so it's really hidden and nobody can see it anymore. But at least with the cable I can use this space, and you can put this dongle wherever, here inside or on any place inside the car, or even you can put it here between. But you still can use it and the dirt will not go inside. The only bad thing with that is you have a switch. You always need to turn it on, or not always, sometimes you need to reset it, turn it on, that it's working. Then if this is on, you can use your cell phone and connect it by Bluetooth with the dongle. And then starting the CanSetE app, and that the device is working, you should always turn on your car. If it's not turned on, the values are sometimes not shown. Then here on the DC power kilowatts, negative 0.3. This means right now the car is consuming 0.3 kilowatts while not driving, only turn on the electronics. You know, nothing is on, the heater is off, the blower is off, but it's still consuming energy. Then below you can see the available range of your battery, but as you know, that's only estimated range. Then you can see the usable state of charge of your battery pack. 78.6% is here, my usable state of charge. Even the usable state of charge shown on the display in the car is always slightly 2 or 3% different from what is shown here. What is very important for me is the mean battery temperature. That's the line at the bottom. Here it says right now 22 degrees, because if it's below 22, 21, sometimes below 20 degrees, it really depends. I can never have the full charging speed. If it's below 21 degrees Celsius, the charging speed of the battery pack will never go above 22, 23 kilowatts. And if the battery is warm, like 22, 23, 24 degrees Celsius, then I have the full, almost 40 kilowatts charging speed. And that's always good to see the battery temperature. So if I'm driving fast, I have a much warmer battery than if it's cold. Yeah, and you can also see different other things on this app. You can check your air pressure in the tire. So we see all four tires are okay with the air pressure. If not, there will be shown something different. You can see the heat map of the battery. That's had nothing to do with temperature. That's some voltage of the cells that it's equal. Yeah, a lot of things you can show. Also with braking, you can see the energy recuperation while braking. And yeah, maybe you can check it by your own, then you can see what's shown here. Also, if you swipe once to the left, there's an extended things to see. If you check the battery, there's a lot of written lines, what you can see. Charging status, plug status, maximum AC, charge, amperes, phases. Yeah, if you connect your battery, you can see how many phases are charging, how many kilowatts power is charging, and different things. But the main thing is, you should always use this Kenway dongle. If you use another one, it's not really shown the right thing, especially not in the real time. Yo, so found out this video about the KenZE app and especially about the dongle. I link you all the things below this video so you can check it out, and if you like to order something, you know which device exactly you need to order. Okay, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet, and if you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. If you don't like, give me a thumbs down. And please, if you give me a thumbs down, write below the video what you don't like, what I can make better. Yeah, just give me some comments below the video so I know how to do better videos. Thank you, and see you soon in my next videos. Bye bye.